If your organization is small, you may only need to create one team site for all of your business needs. However, larger organizations may need multiple team sites based on regional, hierarchical, or departmental divisions, or for different projects. A reason to use multiple team sites is to allow for different levels of control over the features and settings. You can have several team sites owned by different owners with individual settings and permissions. However, if one owner creates multiple team sites, then those team sites will share the same administrative settings and permissions. The owner will create an initial team site, that is the very first top-level site, and then they'd create more sub-sites off from this top-level site. A group of team sites is known as sites. We should consider some of the features and properties available if you're using groups of team sites. The initial team site created has a single root site or top level, and all other team sites branch off from the root. All the team sites within the group will have the same site owners and the same administrative settings, but this can be changed for each of the individual sub-sites. Let's take a look how to create a new SharePoint site. I've signed into my Microsoft 365 Admin Center as a SharePoint administrator and then opened the SharePoint Admin Center. On the left-hand side, under Sites, I'll click Active Sites and then click Create. On the Create a Site page, we need to choose the type of site we want to create. This could be a team site or a communication site. We could also use the other option to create a team site without an Office 365 group, or create a classic site. I'll select a team site. I'll provide a team site name. Enter the details for the group owner. Confirm the language. And I'll review the advanced settings. Here we can configure privacy settings. This can be private or public within the organization. If you configure a site to be private, then individual members need to request access to the site. We'll confirm the time zone and a site description and click Next. We can now configure additional owners and also specify members. Once I'm done, I'll click Finish. The new team site has been created and is now live, and we can see it in the list of active sites. Here we can see the site properties, including members, description, and sharing properties. Each member of the group will receive a welcome email with links to get them started collaborating with the new team site. I can select the link from within the SharePoint Admin Center and launch the team site. Here we can see we have four members and all of the components of the team site have been correctly provisioned. From the home page, I can click plus new and create new documents, new pages, or even add apps to the team site. On the left-hand side, we can click the links to view documents, OneNote notebooks, and site contents. Let's now see how to create a new team subsite on an existing team site. From the team site homepage, I'll click the cog item in the top right-hand corner and select site contents. To create a new subsite, we can then click plus, new, subsite, and then complete the properties. We'll need to provide a title and optional description. And we can define the website address. I'll use internal. We can choose the default language for the website and select a template that we want to use. I'll select the template, team site is the most common, and then notice the permissions and navigation settings are inherited from the parent site, which is recommended. There are a few other settings which we'll leave as default, and then click Create. the subsite is created and presented for customization. I'll click the SharePoint link on top and return to the home page. And now if we click IT Office Move, we can see the breadcrumb of internal comms listed at the top. This represents our new subsite.